Her father David down back there behind the soundboard, and myself, I'm Kim, I'm the mom. I welcome you to Keely's recital and thank you so much for marking this season of her life with us and our gratitude for the gift she is to us. If she didn't have so much music to play, I probably would have made her give her speech. She did a speech all year in speech club, and she took it to the national tournament. And the reason I would have made her give it is because it's appropriate to what we're doing. And so I begged permission to give you the quick synopsis. It started when we were in the car many months ago, and we heard a quote on the classical radio station. And I said, ooh, you should analyze that for a speech. That would be really interesting. And I think I jotted it down or something. But after a while, we couldn't remember what the quote was, and I even emailed the radio station, couldn't remember the quote. But she kind of took that idea and went with it. And so the speech starts out talking about the arts and how we think they're important. And then she said, well, why are they important? And she puts forth the idea that art is a messenger and that it gives a voice to our longing. She gave examples of how art often comes, beautiful art often comes out of ugliness. You know, Beethoven, he was deaf and he created the beautiful music, and Van Gogh was mentally ill and he created the beautiful pictures. And in the work camps of Terezin, the Nazi work camps, the Jews created beautiful music because the guy smuggled in a score of Giuseppe Verdi's Requiem and they performed it. So all these things where people are longing for something beautiful and they use art to give a voice to that longing. But there gets to be a problem, and C.S. Lewis defined it when he said, the things we trusted in, we looked to the music, we looked to the art for the beauty, but it wasn't there. They'll disappoint us if we trust them, something like that. And that's because what we long for isn't in the art. The art has the scent of a flower we've never found, and the echo of a tune we've never heard, and news from a country that we've never visited. And then the part that always made me cry, she said, we all long for a better world. One is coming. And then she gave a brief overview of the gospel, that God created a beautiful world, and that man rebelled and brought brokenness and death and corruption, and that the whole Bible is the story of God's plan to renew all things. And only he can do that. We can't. So the whole point is that the gifts he gives are really beautiful. But since we can't trust them to fulfill us, if we instead turn our attention to the giver, then somehow we get to enjoy the gifts even more because we know they're not going to fulfill us, they're not going to be perfect. Anyway, that's kind of the gist of where we want the recital to go, and let's pray together. Father, I thank you for each person here who's come to celebrate with us. I thank you for Keely and the way she was a little tiny cuddly baby, and now she's a dear friend, a young woman who thinks deeply, makes beautiful music, and is just a joy to have around. Father, I pray that this night would be a little marker to help us hold your gifts more loosely, to look to you for the joy that only that you can provide, that you would give us a deeper hunger for the country that we've never visited, that you are preparing for us. And she's gonna start with some Bach. Oh, and Lord, I wanted to pray extra mercy on the accompanist. Don't let the accompanist mess up too much. In Jesus' name, amen.